brutality that Joseph Kony's LRA rebels inflicted on the people still haunts communities in northern Uganda, though a semblance of peace has returned in the region. During my stay in Agago district, I visited Wanglobo Memorial Site where 28 people were massacred and cooked in pots by the marauding Joseph Kony rebel fighters in 2002. Kadonia Anek was present when the massacre unfolded and narrated the horrifying tale of how her relatives were killed in cold blood.
So when the rebel cut the neck and chopped the tight, she was there and she was putting on a pink skirt. The blood also, by the time they were cutting the neck, she was nearer to the person whose neck is cut.
In the middle of her narration, she is overcome by emotions and briefly stops speaking. Remembering the brutal death of her people evokes pain and anguish. Looking on while Kony's rebels chop off people's heads, hands and legs is something that could traumatize her the rest of her life. Some of the survivors of this massacre were taken into captivity. But she was lucky to have escaped from the clutches of death.
The commander came and asked her to go away because she was having a baby of 3 months.
Two months.
Because many of her close relatives were killed on that fateful night, Anek was left with a burden of looking after many orphans.
Oroma Jacqueline is now 12 years and she's one of the orphans whose parents were killed by the rebels of Joseph Kony.
The memories of this massacre are still fresh in the mind of the Agago District Speaker John Awek, who was at the scene of the massacre the following day.
So when we came, we found one of the heads of the people arrested by Kony was chopped and put in pots, and also the tight. They set the fire on. Yes. So in the process, the head and the tight was getting boiled. But we managed to remove and we destroyed the pot.
The war ended some years back, but the memories of atrocities committed by Joseph Kony's rebels in this place are still alive on people's minds. And on every 22nd of October, every year, people converge here with their bishops to pray and remember the people who were massacred and cooked in this place. So will the people of this place forgive Kony?
Even at the moment that you are interviewing me, I am recalling all the events that happened in this place. And I'm shocked. I'm just talking because I'm now a leader. I should have shed tears. So when you talk about forgiving Kony, I don't agree with that really. Because a good number of my relatives were also killed in this place.
Local leaders here say the president promised to help survivors, but no support has been forthcoming.
And we are not happy. So I want to send my cry on behalf of my people that government comes up with some assistance because there are orphans, widows and widowers who are really living a very devastating life.
Though the war is over, the population in northern Uganda is still grappling with psychosocial problems, with the scars and trauma of the war yet to heal. Former abductees spent much of their day drinking. The much-vaunted Marshall Plan to rehabilitate northern Uganda is yet to take off.
If government could put some vocational school in this place, so that for those children who cannot proceed to A-level, they can now branch to technical schools.
So we need government to assist us with vocational school here. Because we are plotting, we have nothing to do.
The effects of the LRA insurgents continue to stalk northern Uganda. Many homes in this district are headed by children. We found this 13-year-old girl selling pancakes to make a living and fend for her siblings. Agness Nandutu, NTV, Agago District.